In this video, you will learn what a flow variable is and how to create and use it. Let's look into that. In this workflow, we read in some sales data, filter the entries for Germany, calculate the total revenue, and finally rename the total revenue column to Germany. This workflow works fine for the country of Germany. However, if you want to obtain the same table for the USA, you need to change the configuration of both the row filter and the column renamer nodes. This is a simple workflow, but if you had a more complex workflow with more nodes and settings to update, it would be inefficient and error-prone to reconfigure it manually. This is exactly where you need flow variables. A flow variable is a parameter in a nine-block flow to override nodes configuration settings. In our example, you can control nodes settings, configuring the country with a parameter, flow variable, to execute the workflow for different countries without manually changing the settings. Similar to data columns, flow variables can be of different types: string, integer, double, arrays, or path. There are different ways to create a flow variable. Let's first have a look at how we can export a node's configuration as a flow variable. Now that we have defined the filtering pattern Germany in the row filter node, we can export it as a flow variable and reuse this pattern in the downstream nodes. Filtering pattern is a common setting to be controlled by a flow variable in the row filter node. Therefore, for this setting there is a special flow variable button to both control and export this setting. We can export it by clicking the checkbox and writing the name of the flow variable, country. Less common configuration settings don't have a special flow variable button, but all the settings can be controlled and exported in the flow variables tab. You can see that the pattern setting is here too. In the node monitor in the flow variables tab, you can now find the variable country with value Germany. Once created, flow variables are passed to all downstream nodes in a workflow branch. Therefore, the country variable can be used by the subsequent nodes in the workflow. Another way to create a flow variable is by using a dedicated node. This can be, for instance, configuration nodes, table row or column to variable nodes, or the variable creator node. The variable creator node is very simple. It allows you to create multiple variables of different types. Table row or column to variable nodes create a flow variable from the first row or column of the input table, respectively. Configuration nodes can be useful when you want to prompt a user to provide a variable of a particular type in a dedicated node or a component. In our example, we need to create a flow variable of type string, therefore we use a string configuration node. We set the name of the flow variable to country and the default value to Germany. The red circle at the node output indicates a flow variable port and contains the created variable. Now, to use this flow variable, we'll have to pass it to the row filter node. Each node has input and output flow variable ports in their left and right upper corners. They get visible when you hover over them. By connecting the string configuration and row filter nodes, we create a red flow variable connection that you can use to pass variables to any nodes. Now, in the row filter node, we can use this flow variable to control the filtering pattern setting. We click the flow variable button, tick the option Use variable, and select the variable country. Now that we use the variable created in the configuration node, we can untick the Create Variable option. As before, if we needed to control a setting that doesn't have a flow variable button, we could do it in this Flow Variables tab. Let's also overwrite a setting for the column renamer node. We don't have to connect the string configuration and the column renamer explicitly, as the flow variable is being passed through the whole branch. Starting with 9 version 5, some nodes have an updated configuration window, as for instance the column renamer node. Similar to classic configuration window settings that are commonly controlled by flow variables, they have a dedicated flow variable button. In our case, we want to rename the sum amount column with the selected country name, and hence we select the country variable from the drop-down menu. To control or export all configuration settings by or as flow variables, you can right-click the node and select Configure Flow Variables. You can see that the records got filtered for Germany and the total revenue column got renamed to Germany. Let's now execute the same workflow for sales in the USA. In the string configuration node, we change the value to USA and execute the whole workflow. You can see that the records got filtered for the USA and the column got renamed accordingly. Note that we didn't change any setting in the workflow. They got automatically adjusted by the flow variable we provided in the string configuration node. In this video, you have learned what a flow variable is, when it is useful, and how to create and use flow variables to control node settings and to automate parts of your workflow.